Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about finding the commutator for given functions. Moving on to the topic. In the first question, we are given with two operators, x cubed and px, and we are asked to find commutator for this one. So as we all know, some function given, like if it is commuting with each other, the order is very important. Like if in this question, upon B operator, A operator is acting. And according to this, on A operator, B operator is acting. If both the values are equal, then these two are commuting with each other, and we will be able to write this commutator in this format. That means we are just taking this one to the left hand side and equating with 0. So moving on to the function operators we are given with, we are asked to find the commutator for these two operators. So according to our property, we are going to write in this format. That means our psi operator is first acting upon px, that means a linear momentum operator, and on that our x cubed is acting. And here our psi wave function is acting upon x cubed, then to that value our linear momentum operator is acting. So now in the second step, we are trying to put the value of linear momentum operator. So that means x cubed, as such we are writing, then px, that means linear momentum operator, we are writing it minus I h cut dou by dou x, and psi we are writing, after multiplication I have written this, minus px means linear momentum operator, this one, and the same thing we are writing. Moving on to the next step, this nothing to do, so we have to multiply everything together, and we are writing it here, minus minus sign is coming. Then here we have to apply our product rule. According to product rule, this is our product rule, d by dx of the two operators or two functions we are given with, when dx is operating, first function into derivative of second function minus second function into derivative of first function. So according to this product rule, we are trying to open this bracket. So this one we are writing as such, and product rule we are applying to this side. So first function into derivative of this function, so we have to confirm with these term how it is coming, plus this function into derivative of this function. So actually one mistake is there, here it is actually plus sign. So then we are equating that to 0. Then upon opening the bracket, we'll be seeing these two terms will be equal. This term and these two terms will be equal, so cancel it. Then we are left with these term and these two minus sign and IH cut. So altogether we are multiplying and writing it here. So then we have to take this psi common outside, and the commutator for the given function is this one. And here I have given the general format. If a function is given in this format, its commutator will be in this format. It's better to find the commutator after solving, but if you're comfortable to by heart these, it will be okay if you're by hearting this. The second question is, you are asked to find the commutator for d by dx operator and x cubed operator. So if a wave function is acting upon these two operators, first consider a wave function is acting upon x cubed, and to that value our dx is dx operator is coming, and minus x cubed d by dx of psi, and we are equating that to 0. So here we have to apply the product rule. So first function into derivative of second function plus second function into derivative of this first function, that means x cubed will be 3x square, minus, we are just opening the bracket and writing it. So we'll be seeing these two terms are equal, and we are cancelling it, and we are left with this term. So when we are rearranging this term, psi will be outside, and this will be the commutator for this given operator. And here also I have given general formula. If d by dx and x in nx raised to n. If in this cases, if d by dx is coming in the front side, your answer will be having a plus sign. Like the same way we have done. Here d by dx is coming and answer is having a plus sign. And the second one, x raised to n is coming in the front side. So you'll be having an minus in the answer section. And rest everything will be equal. Just a plus and minus game it is. And in the third question, we are asked to find the commutator for px and x square. So the same way we are giving a wave function. So we will be able to write this in this format, and we'll be able to equate that to zero. And now we are just rewriting px in terms of its formula, that linear momentum operator. Just here also we are writing that. Then upon opening the bracket, that means we have to apply product rule here. Minus I h cut will be same, then we'll be writing minus I h cut here. Upon acting the product rule, first function into derivative of second function plus second function into derivative of first function. That means x square, if it is x square, it will be 2x plus this 2 will be coming plus. Then we are just multiplying this whole together and writing it. That will be equal to 0. Then just we are trying to open the bracket by giving these minus I h cut to these two. So you will be finding the first term and this term which we have written here will be equal, and we have to cancel these two and we will be left with this term. That means minus I h cut 2x into psi. And upon writing this psi aside, you will be left with minus I h cut 2x, and this is the given commutator for the given function, for the given operator. Here I have given some general formulas. Now you can take the screenshot of these general formulas if you want. But according to my opinion, rather than by hearting all these formulas, solving will be good. You will be getting a practice and exposure to as much as questions, so your speed will be increasing. So at the time of exam, you don't have to get panic. If you have any doubt regarding this topic, post those questions in the comment section. Thank you.